Hello children, how are you all? I hope you all are fine. Now, I am here with another video which is based on the muscular tissue and nervous tissue. In this video, I will explain you muscular tissue and the nervous tissue. Already we have studied in the previous videos epithelial tissues and the connective tissues. As you can see here, the muscular tissues are of three kinds. That means the muscles are of three kinds here: striated muscles, non-striated muscles, and cardiac muscles. Okay, so basically these two are the, this one is the voluntary, that means it depends on our own wish and will, and these two are called the involuntary muscles, that means it does not depend on our wish or will. Muscles tissues, or you can say muscular tissues, are contractile tissues. Okay, that means they are having the ability to contract. Okay, and once they will contract, then another time they will get relaxed also. And the flesh of our body is formed from the muscular tissues only. Okay, they are the fibrous ones. They are known as the muscle fibers. Fibers means the long cells are there. Okay, and they are having the highly contractile myofibrils. What are myofibrils? They are the contractile proteins. Okay, so for the formation of muscles, we need lots of proteins. Okay, as you all know that protein is very important for the growth. So when you are growing, that means your muscles are increasing and the flesh of the body is also increasing. Okay, these muscle fibers are arranged either in sheets or in the bundles. Okay, they are arranged in a sheet wise or in a big group of bundles. Now children, can you identify these people? This is Salman Khan, this is Ajay Devgan, then so many are there, you might be knowing very well in comparison to more than me, you know them and you are fascinated with them. Okay, you can see what is the common thing in them, that they all are having the muscles. Okay, they are working a lot for the formation of muscles. Okay, that's why they are making biceps, triceps and six-pack ab, four-pack ab and like that. You must be much familiar than me. Okay, so here it is what they have done. They have done lots of work, lots of exercises to form this. Okay, so you see that for single one step, okay, listen carefully, for single one step your 200 muscles are active. Okay, they show the movement. Okay, 200 muscles, when they show the movement, then only you are able to take one step. Okay, and every day you should take around 10,000 steps. Okay, so it's my request, please don't sit in front of the TV for longer time. At least 10,000 steps you have to cover every day so that your muscles should remain active. Okay, now children, one by one we will study about the different types of muscular tissues, location, structure and functions. Now striated muscles are attached to the bones. Okay, structure found as bundles, long and cylindrical fibers have light and dark colored bands. Okay, and what it does, help in movement of bones and body parts and help in locomotion. Since you all know that this is the voluntary muscles, that means it depends on our own wish and will. When we want to walk, then only it will move, otherwise it will not move. And they are attached to the bones. This is the structure of striated muscles. Okay, they are found as bundles, long and cylindrical fibers. Okay, have the light and dark colored bands. You can see very easily. Okay, this is called as striated muscles. Now next is the non-striated muscles, that is the involuntary muscles. Okay, so it is the location in the walls of alimentary canal, your intestine. Okay, then blood vessels which carries the blood. Okay, and the urinary bladder. Urinary bladder is there to store the urine. Okay, so structure, what is that? Found as sheets or sphincters, spindle shaped long fibers, no dark and light bands. And what is the function? Help in the movement of food and urine. It's not like that. This involuntary muscles are present in the alimentary canal, that is a long large intestine, small intestine. So it's not like that you people used to say stop to the small intestine and stop to the large intestine. So it is what? It does not depend on your wish or will. Okay. So you cannot say statue and it will stop. Okay. It doesn't need any kind of instruction from you. It will work by itself. But because you see, as soon as you start eating the food, okay, what happens? It goes inside and your stomach will start working, your intestine will start working, small intestine will work, large intestine will work. And another is what? Urine. Okay, that is the movement, filtration of the urine and all that. That happens by itself. So here you can see the non-striated muscles. Okay, they are the found in the sheets and spindle shaped long fibers, and they are not having the dark and light bands. Okay, as it was there in the striated muscles. Okay, so this is the shape of non-striated muscles or involuntary muscles. And the last one is the cardiac muscles. Okay, this is also involuntary muscle. It does not depend on your wish or will. And this muscle is only found in the walls of the heart. Okay, and what is the structure? Found as a network, cylindrical and branch fibers, and have light and dark bands. Okay, the shades will be there. And what it does? It helps in pumping blood to different parts of the body. This is the structure of the cardiac muscles. Okay, found as a network. Okay, cylindrical and branched. You can see the branching over here, and have light and dark bands. That's why you can see the shades in the heart muscles or the cardiac muscles. See, these cardiac muscles will work throughout your life. Okay, throughout your life, any person life. Okay, anybody's life. So what is that? The day they will rest, the person will be rest in peace. You know, rest in peace when it is told. Okay, so what is that? This cardiac muscles will never rest, and the day it will rest, then the person will be called as rest in peace. Now children, here you see the original structure of your heart. Okay, it is the original structure of your heart is like this. Okay, when it is filled with the blood. Okay, and in this is also your heart. Here only the cardiac muscles are shown. Okay, when the blood is drained out from your heart, it looks like this. Okay, so this is the heart which is without the blood. See how nice it is. Okay, now children, can you tell which is the strongest muscles in the human body? Yes, as you can see in the picture, the tongue is the strongest muscle in the human body. So here you can see that you know very well, in fact, that many things you used to do with your tongue, and whole day it keeps on moving, and you are eating, you are talking, you are chewing the food. So every time this one is working, and that is why it is the strongest muscles of the human body. Now children, moving towards the last tissue, that is the nervous tissue. Here we are going to study about nervous tissue, not in detail, that you will study in 8th standard. Okay, children, you can see this picture. So basically nervous tissues are present where? In the brain, spinal cord, and the nerves which are spread in your whole body. Your brain is formed from the nervous tissues, then spinal cord, and this whole nerves. Now we will study about what is the basic structural and functional unit of nervous tissue. Because all together this form the nervous system. Okay, this nervous system. So this nervous tissue are the special one. Okay, they are the special ones, and they are formed from the cell called the neuron, special cells, or you can say the nerve cells, and they are known as the neurons. These neurons are found in all your sense organs. Okay, that's why you are able to feel. See, the sense organ is skin. That's why you are able to feel touch, pressure, temperature. Then it is present in the tongue also. That's why you are able to taste the things. Then in your eyes, that's why you are able to have the sense of vision. Then ears, sound and balance. And through the nose, you can smell, the sense of smell. Okay, the sense of hearing, sound. Okay, so this all sense organs are having the neurons or the nervous tissue. Now here you can see the structure of a nerve cell or a neuron. Okay, it's very interesting and very nice diagram, beautiful one you can say, and this is my favorite diagram also. So basically, if you will see this, it seems like a tree. Okay, a tree, just like it is having the roots, okay, then stem, and then branches. Okay, main tree. Okay, so in this way you can remember that it is just similar with the tree. Okay, as you can see here, the neuron is having three parts. This is the cell body or the cyton. Okay, then a long cylindrical process that is called the axon, and this is the axon endings or the axon terminals. And here you can see the short branches are there. Okay, that is called the dendrons. Okay, this one is the dendrons, and from there that structure comes out, that is called the dendrites. This is the cell body, and here is the nucleus. You know that without the nucleus the cell cannot survive. Okay, and it is covered with a myelin sheath. It's a myelin sheath. Myelin is a kind of fat which is covering it. Okay, so one by one we will study this one, how it works. Here another diagram you can see. This is the dendrites, cell body, axon. Now direction of the message will go from here to here, this way, from the cell body to the axon and then to the axon terminals. So this is the axon terminals with dendrites on target cell. Then another axon, another cell will be attached with this. That is, the neuron will be attached. Okay, in detail we will study in 8th standard. Okay, one more diagram you can see here, that it's axon, and then the message from here it comes out and then it reaches here, then to the another neuron. How it goes? It gets transferred to the through the synapse. Okay, the place where the two neurons meet. Okay, and then they pass on the electrical impulses. Okay, children, you can see this is the nervous system. Okay, it is here the brain is there, then spinal cord, and the nerves are coming out. These all are made up of this kind of cells, that is the neurons. Okay, and what is the function of this? As I have shown you this figure before also, that they will take the stimulus from the environment and give it to the brain and the spinal cord in the form of nerve impulse, and accordingly you will react. So students, hope you all have understood the topics. If you have any doubt or question, you can ask in the comment section below. Please like, share it with your classmates, subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell icon so that you can get my latest updates. Thank you and take care.